Hi, my name's Mathew Jury. I work for TASKA Prosthetics. I'm the product director, and my job is to gather product information for what we might develop in the future. And I'm qualified in electronics with an NZCE.
Yeah, my name's Dave Lovegrove. I'm head of design here at TASKA Prosthetics. I'm a trained mechanical engineer, but my job here is to lead the teams in terms of design and development of the products.
In 2002, I had a mountain biking accident and broke both my arms, and I was without the use of them for about two, three weeks with them both in plaster. And I was fascinated by the my electric hands that were coming on the market at the time. So that was really what got it started, was actually being able to relate to being an amputee for a short period anyway, and also that fascination with small machines. So we make myoelectric hands, and in particular multi-articulating hands, which means motor for each finger. What makes us a little different is that our hand is the most robust hand on the market. So one of the key things about the hand's function is it's got flexible digits around the knuckles, so they can be push-pulled like a shock absorber. And that means if you whack the hand on a table, or you walk past the door frame and you clip the hand, it doesn't break because of the sideways pressure.
The design process really starts with the users, and then develops a lot of ideation and problem solving. It's a transdisciplinary team, so the industrial design, product design, mechanical engineering, you know, software and electronics all work together. You know, we want our hands to be lasting a good 5 years in the market, doing everyday things all day for a user. And that's a real challenge when you think of your skin regenerating itself as regularly as it does. So our process is to make sure that we are confident that it can do that. We like to talk about everyday activities, and what our product does for a user is allow them to get outside and do things that they would possibly ordinarily have done when they had two hands. So yeah, they can get out and wash the car, they can do some gardening, you know, it just gives them a lot more freedom and flexibility. It allows them just to get out and do everyday things.
When the patient isn't having to think, how do I protect this device from breaking when I'm trying to achieve making dinner, for argument's sake, it has quite a burden on the way they're thinking. And so the fact that the hand is just simply tough means that they don't have to think too hard about doing the task. They can literally push a knife between fingers because they'll splay, and there's no risk. Low cognitive load, we call it, because they don't have to think.
Yeah, there's a lot of things that probably you and I would just take for granted. You know, just doing a zipper up on your jeans, you know, opening doors, shaking hands, all these type of things that you do naturally and without thinking becomes quite a big challenge for people that have lost their hand. So being able to give them the confidence to go out and do stuff again with a myoelectric TASKA prosthetic is, you know, a great thing to be able to do.
Get a hand that can go on a woman is imperative to us as one of the next steps. And obviously we'll be looking to have a smaller hand in the future. Most of the patients that we have worked with have already had a different manufacturer's hand, and just the difference for them in being able to just get on with life, that's the difference. And we're not talking about rocket ships here, we're talking about being able to wash your hands. We're talking about being able to do a bit of work in the garage without having to think about it. Walking in the rain, I mean, these are just basic things that this product allows. And we get positive comments through our Twitter feeds and the like every day.